So I just got off the 6 at the previous stop and walked down to this one to catch the Portland streetcar to go to OHSU for a medical appointment. They told me not to wear any body lotions, so I guess I'm going to be getting all sorts of sticky things stuck to me today. That's fine. Give me something to do. This is MLK. I'm outside of the convention center, and there's a Comic-Con going on. It's not very crowded, and it's cleaned up quite a bit around here lately. It's not nearly as bad as it was. But that's it. Look at the sky. This is the first time it's been like this in a long time. I hope it rains. Here comes the streetcar with that sound it makes, like War of the Worlds. This is the inside of the Portland streetcar. This is car 004. I don't know, I think they have like 20 cars. Small single car units that are articulated in the middle. You know, Boston was the first transit company that had articulated cars back around 1905 or 10, and they took two horse cars and made them at the ends, and then they put a new section in the middle, and they called it two rooms and a bath. And you can look that up, something you didn't know yesterday. And aboard the Portland streetcar going to OHSU. We're on MLK, just outside the convention center. You hear that noise. These things crawl along because they have their own stops as well as having to stop for the traffic lights. Now passing over. Just passing over I-84. That's the beginning of it. There. New construction. Yellow flashing light, that's for us. stuff again. Art Deco building. The Miller Paint Company uses that color yellow on all their buildings. It's so pretty. Art Deco. The Hotel Grand Stark. It's not open yet. Just before the COVID hit, that was a furniture store that had been there for over 100 years, like Schoenlands or something like that. They started rehabbing the building and then COVID hit, so it stopped. $3.87 a gallon for gas. They're out of their minds. But we have to pay it.
Southeast MLK and Forest. Please view priorities
where the number 6 bus goes up that ramp and swings around and then goes over that bridge. That's the Hawthorne Bridge. King went out of business.
Southeast MLK and Mill. To request a stop, please press the yellow strip or the red button.
Now going on to private right of way. That's the OHSU station for the MAX. They're going over this bridge we're about to go over. And this is the only place on the whole, both of the MAX or the Portland streetcar system that shares trackage. They both run on the same gauge track. Crossing over the Willamette River. You can see the tram going up, the gondola car going up the cable. Thank you. That's the train I was just on. That traffic up there is I-5. The ramp going over to 26, I think. And then this is the other, one of the other streetcars. They have two routes. Now this will go to the Pearl District. The MAX going over into the station. And the bus going into the station. And the Portland streetcar will go through the station, but it does not share stations with MAX. It shares the same trackage over the bridge, and that's it. So this streetcar here will then turn onto the bridge, but it won't stop. It's at the stop now. Got to wait for the light though, because those trains are right there, and the bus. This area of Portland, I think would be considered like the equivalent of Boston's waterfront, harborfront, or whatever their South Boston new neighborhood is called, Harborside or whatever it is. It's the same thing as this, all new big tall buildings. Most of these are vacant though, or else they're leased by medical offices. Behind it, those are residential condos. You can see the tops of them. They're mostly empty. Very, very, very expensive. And this is really isolated down here. And then there's the tram to the hospital at the top of the hill. There's more housing down there that they built. They just keep building. And there's like nobody living in them. And the streetcar was put in for these buildings. The OHSU Tram. And it swings. Oh, God, I hate that. And it swings and swings. until it gets to the next one. Pass through the MAC station, but we don't stop. And then it swings off onto its own track again, although they share all of them. At this point, we'll go off the bridge and then we're going to run down MLK. At one point, we'll cross the onto MLK and go the wrong direction. Oh, it's after this next bridge. And we'll run on MLK in the wrong direction for a block. Over the rail lines, is quite busy. I think there's like a train museum here or something. There's old trains and very active rail line.
Proof of valid fare is required on Portland Streetcar.
It's grand. The light changes and then we run against the traffic to get to that street over there. Shared by this and the number 6 bus, and I'll just get on the 6 bus for the rest of the way home. Pretty convenient. Oh, here we go. California plate, and a minute ago I saw a Florida one. I see a lot of out-of-state plates around here.
Please hold on while the streetcar is in motion.